Jay Stevens 2010. I'm going to do a camping bag review today and also go through the contents. This isn't my bug out bag, but it is something that I go out with and I'm constantly tweaking. Enjoy. The bench here so we can take a look. Nothing fancy. This was about a $20 bag. Got mainly for hunting. Turkeys, things like that. I carry some stuff, but it's kind of evolved into my camp pack. Got it at Walmart. It was a Field line. I'd say this is about 6-7 years old. Right on the side, we'll go around the outside. I've got one of these S beaners. Okay, I kind of like those. These little clip-ons. These 90s S ringed. Basically, you can get them on and get them off. If you go camping at all, you realize when you're cleaning up, you need one of these. It's like a pot scraper with a little scrub brush. I also kind of just put that on, keep it on outside next to my utensils. This one's made by MSR. This was the Sea to Summit, about 16 bucks. I don't know. What was it? Hard anodized 7075 T6 alloy. Good Civil War set. Alright, and then I got the same equivalent, Sea to Summit, the long one, for getting down in pots and MREs and whatnot. So, again, my concept is keep it on the outside. Not going super tactical, right? This is camping. I don't care if things jiggle, make noise. Just spin the pack around a little bit more. I've got my accessible survival knife type of deal. I just kind of just hang it off it. I just drape things. Already done separate reviews. If you're interested in any of that, just check out my other videos. This was a Gerber saw. Real easy. They work pretty good if you're a saw guy, hatchet guy, whatever. Same concept. Another one of these 90s. Type things, and I just it's kind of like improvised Molly. You just if you need to get it off, you just take it off. I also bolt on, went and picked up more. I don't really care about colors. Got a couple small ones, a couple big ones, 3-4 bucks each, $2 each. Walmart, sporting goods stores type of deal. This particular one, I must have got this in one of the tactical stores. I don't know. Just because I could. Non-load bearing. But, I don't know. These work a lot better. This thing, I'm a little iffy. If you have something important, I don't know if I'd hold it on this. But I would this, so. Okay, well, we're going to do the outside pockets. I got a lower section, I got an inner section, and I got a couple of zip pockets on the side. Let's take a look here. I think what I store in here is just a plastic poncho. Basically, that's all I can get there. Other side, I used to have an all-weather radio. It broke on me, but I went into a little yellow. NOAA weather radio, kind of have that. And we're going to start at the bottom. I've got a travel pillow, ultra light, man. I mean, this thing is like ounces. So you guys see my other video where I've got my big Agnes. Well, this is the pillow, smooth as silk. All right, haven't tried this yet, just bought it. But packs up real nice. I mean, it is nothing. Alright, looking forward to that. Every camp, you can see some of my videos. This is one of these UCO lights. Okay, UCO. Right. It's basically a flashlight. Let's see. low, an SOS mode, high. Okay? And then what's cool about it, you can kind of have a light, and then you just pull the thing apart and it becomes like a dome light. I think this is about 50, 60 lumens. So kind of cool. This is about, has a little hanger too. You can hang it up, you know, put it in one of those type of capacities. So this light is actually on the higher end, you know, I think it was like 20 bucks. And it's waterproof or water resistant, I think. So this is pretty good. What else do I have in this pouch? Bug, poison ivy, pain relief, stingies, right? My son needed a little, he got bit up by mosquitoes. This is what I broke out. Man, he was itching. This helped a little bit. You can get one of these 70 sprays. Just get it and throw it in your pack. This I got off eBay. One of the guys making little tins and survival kits. I'm not going to inventory this. But this is kind of the backup of the backup next to the backup. All kinds of little stuff. One day I did have to use a match from in here. But it's got a bobber and fishing kits and tinder and a little light. But, you know, the concept is you have a little something just in case. All right. I mostly leave that in my bag. I don't carry that with me. In a waterproof bag, separate review. This is my shortwave radio, AM/FM radio, extra batteries, extension, and my long cable. I kind of keep all that nice and tidy in a waterproof bag. This is great for breaking, having music when you're out there. Break that out. And it's in a nice case. Except it's already reviewed. Amp 3 IFAC. It's, again, separate review. Beefed up flashlight, my own little flashlight, things like that. So it's all in a waterproof kit. Good to have. A little backup with some aspirin, things like that. Just threw that in the kit. That is it for this main accessory pouch. Let's go up top a little bit into this one. And this one is my fire starting. All right, I've got my blast match, previously reviewed. You know, since I have my camping wear, my cookware in the bag as well, you always need some wilderness wash. About $3. Little dab will do you. Okay, in here, couple 1 liter platypuses. I like these. This is different from the Nalgene. I can just roll these up. So that's the beauty of this type of water bottle setup. Knife sharpener, in case you want to get out on the trail, play around, sharpen a knife. It's one of those type of formats. You just run your knife through there. Works fair. It's okay. 511 ATAC A1, previously reviewed, okay, by 511. Can't beat it. Good to always have a flashlight. And Trioxane fuel tabs. I think I bought a 6-pack of the wet fires as well. So I stuffed the wet fires in there. I like to have a lot of options. Wet fires, trioxane, there's a trioxane. Let me keep trucking. May have to speed up. Oh, that was the cocoon. That was my travel pillow. Self-inflatable. Okay, get out on the trails. I picked up one of these things for knots. It's kind of neat, right? All these different kinds. You want to play around, experiment, bowline, whatnot. Got one of those. Backup silverware. Guys I go camping with, relatives and whatnot, have to go back to the old school. They may not have their own silverware like I had, so I give them this. A couple earplugs. You always need earplugs. You're camping with somebody and they're snoring their ass off. I learned the hard way. Bring some earplugs. A couple extra clips for some targets that broke. A couple extra batteries. Probably should have those sealed up. But That's the main pouch. It's my fire starting, my knives, my flashlight, and my water bottle, stuff I can grab easy. And down here was the radio, first aid kit, little mini survival kit, and light, things I can grab easy. Okay, I'm going to speed up, guys, because I'm trying to keep the video under 15. The bag, I mean, this is a cheap bag. I want to replace it. That'll be in the next video. I can't complain. I mean, the straps held up, but I mean, it's very basic, typical stuff. All right, speeding up. In here, a mini first aid kit, fishing kit, double decker. Okay, on this side, I've got beetle spins, flies, I've got a black gant, glow trout. This is a panther martin. Okay, this is good for catching crappie and trouts, extra hooks, and I got some gulp bait. Okay, a couple different type of small fish hook, pin fish hooks, different types, weights and swivels, and a couple of bobbers. Okay, all fits in this nice little kit, about $8. Okay, you never know when you need a fishing kit, all right, especially if you do any fishing and you need to get some food, bring that. A funnel. I haven't really used this yet. This is for like pouring whiskey into one of those little flasks. I just kind of stuffed it in there. I haven't broken that out yet. Good to get out there and have a little something to drink. This is my mess kit. You guys have seen this. MSR pot. And previously reviewed. Fire starting. So there you go. 1.1 liter there. Stash of hot chocolate. Need that for the mornings. Fuel canister. I'm trying to burn this up. This is big. I don't normally carry them that big. USGI canteen. Somebody's on your party, doesn't have a mug, needs something to boil. All right, give them their portion. One of these. All right. Backup fuel canister with a crunch it, so you can just kind of break these down. This is jet boil. I don't get into brands. I just go with whatever's the cheapest. And it kind of stores like that. Sauce or spices. I do carry one of these. Keep it from leaking everywhere. I put it in a waterproof bag. Okay. Paprika, cayenne, garlic salt, black pepper. Comes in handy if you got to spice up some MREs. Emergency roll of toilet tissue. Enough said. Mosquito coils. Break those out. Whether they work or not, mixed results. Snake bite kit. Don't leave home without it. $16. With the suction, do not use the old school where you cut it with a knife and suck the venom out. You're way behind if you're, you know, depending on that. You need the new stuff. Trash, garbage, whatever. Let me speed up. MRE stash. Breakfast, granola, bananas, milk. A yakisoba noodle, lived in Japan. That's kind of cool, one to try it. Creme brulee, you know, a little comfort item at night. Mountain House, one to try that, a granola. Yes, I stack up on these. People like it when you break out a whole inventory. Louisiana red beans and rice. And a little dessert, a little corn. Threw that in as a side item. And in my last pocket, last but not least, I'm going to do a separate review on this. Alpine Air Foods, give their stuff a shot. Mountain Chili. And the Big Daddy, can't go wrong with a Mountain House Beef Stroganoff. That's it, folks. That's in my review. You might say that my, Katadyn water filter. That's it.